avenue are the same thing. The slope and the rate are, for all intents and purposes, the exact same thing. They're equal to each other. So this is like saying at 5 seconds, there was, this is kind of a weird thing to say, like -3 inches of water. Maybe that thing is buried in the ground or something, and the water level is below ground, and that's why it's negative. And then at 5 seconds, there's 8 inches of water. Okay? Just think about that for a second. Do you think it's possible for at 5 seconds there to be -3 inches of water, and then at 5 seconds, notice it's the exact same time, for there to be 8 inches of water?
Yeah, you can like have it negative, and you can dump in a water of like a bucket of water.
How much time did that take?
0 seconds. You can be like.
No, that does not take 0 seconds.
1 second.
Nothing takes 0 seconds except for not doing anything at all. It would take some amount of time, wouldn't it?
Maybe.
So would it still be 5 seconds?
No. Vanishes it right there. Boom.
Okay, so there would have to be some kind of teleportation, vanishing, something that takes 0 seconds, which is not real. Okay?
It's
something that we have the ability to make happen. We can joke about it and talk about science fiction, but it's not something we can do. It is not possible for there to be -3 inches, right? The water, the top of the water to be at -3 inches, and then at the exact same instant for it to be also at 8 inches.
They get up two different cups when it disintegrates.
But it's not two different cups, it's the same cup. We're talking about one cup being filled with water. So it just doesn't seem possible, first of all. If we were to just go ahead and go forward and say, okay, let's see how much the height changed over how much time it took, right? Inches per seconds, right? Well, to find out how much the inches change, we could take 8 minus -3 over how many seconds went by. Well, 5 seconds minus 5 seconds. We already talked about this, so there's 0 seconds have passed. So we have to have a change of, 8 minus -3, that's really 8 plus 3, that's 11. So we have to have an increase of 11 inches in 0 seconds. Can that happen?
No,
nope.
Not possible.
Not physically possible in the real world as we know it.
Unless.
Okay? Not unless you're not going to teleport water. And even if you teleport water, it does take some time to teleport things.
Maybe
it doesn't take 0 seconds. Still, different times.
These
times are exactly the same. 5 seconds exactly. These x's are exactly the same. If we were to look at this on the plane, 5 -3 and 5 8. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, the line that goes through that, how would you describe that line? It's
vertical.
Vertical, right. Straight up and down is vertical. Straight left and right, that's horizontal. Okay. We go up 11, and we don't go up, we don't go over at all, right? So we would say that since our slope is this number, 11 divided by 0, and dividing by 0 is a no-no. You can't divide by 0. It's impossible. We call this slope undefined. It's impossible to have a slope of 11 over 0. And if you think about it in the context of a water filling in a glass being filled with water, it's impossible to see 11 inches of increase with absolutely 0 seconds passing. Not 0.2 seconds, 0 seconds. If 0.2 seconds passed, then we can say something about it, but exactly 0 seconds have passed. Okay? So undefined, impossible, it's not a slope that exists or is conceivable, it's an undefined slope. So does that answer that question for 14? Does that make sense? If we get a 0 in the denominator, we have an undefined slope. And if we put it in the context of something like a car traveling or a cup filling with water or people walking into a stadium or whatever, it just doesn't make any sense. We have to have an increase of 11 over 0 seconds. That doesn't make any sense. Next. Next, I forgot what was next. 25 and 31. Five. A word problem. Right. pitch, what carpenters call the pitch of a roof. Carpenters refer to the slope of a roof as the pitch of the roof. So this roof is on top of this house. Four feet this way. So it's 12 feet horizontal, 4 feet vertical. Okay? If I were to look at that as a line on the plane, thanks for joining me. Thank you. Remember, we're looking for the change in y over the change in x. Right? One of these is vertical, one of these is horizontal. Is y vertical or horizontal?
Vertical.
Y goes vertical, and x goes which way?
Horizontal.
Okay, so we want a vertical change over a horizontal change. Okay, when we look at it on the graph, we see that it's a vertical change over a horizontal change. Okay. So what's the vertical change here? From here up to here.
4 feet.
How much does it change horizontally?
12.
12 feet. Well, the feet are going to divide each other. We have no more units. We just have the fraction 4 over 12, which can be simplified to 1 over 3. We could think of it as 1 foot to 3 feet. Every 1 foot we go up, we go over 3 feet, up 1 over 3, up 1 over 3, up 1 over 3. We do that 4 times. We've got up a total of 4 and over a total of 12.
Not nicely.
One of those is a 1. That's the way to think of it. Okay, so just an example of people using slope in everyday life. Carpenters call it the pitch. Okay. When you're driving in a road, they call it the grade. Right? The grade of a road, a 6% grade, a 3% grade, 2% grade. It's just a measure of the vertical over the horizontal. Last one, 31. Okay, so we've got a graph to look at first. We've got one at our point at 8. And a point at 32 and 2.4. And try to draw it as it is in the book. It should go through these 2 points and through the origin. Okay. So this is the cost of driving on a turnpike. This is how much money it costs you, and this is how many miles you drive. Okay, first find the slope of the line. It's a positive slope. It goes to the right, that's positive. Also goes up, that's positive, so it has a positive slope. Okay. We need the vertical change in y. The change in x. Okay. In this case, what does y represent? What kind of things does y represent?
Cost.
In what units?
Decimals. Dollars.
I would guess dollars. I guess I didn't. Yeah, it does say dollars. So this is dollars. And what does x represent?
Miles.
And so our slope represents a rate. What rate? What kind of a rate is that? What per what?
Dollars per mile.
Dollars per mile is the kind of rate we get when we consider this. So you get a positive slope because we see an increase. More miles, more dollars. Okay? If it was more miles and less dollars, what kind of a slope would we have?
Negative
slope. We see this going down and get negative slope. It's going up, so it's a positive slope. Alright. So what is the change in y between these 2 points?
I have a question, it's not what that question is.
Okay, but my question is, what's the change in y? Which is y change between these 2 points. This point, where is this point right there?
0.6.
8, and it's actually 0.6. And this one is at where?
2.24.
32.
32. And 2.4.
X always go first.
Yeah.
Okay.
When you write those two numbers, yeah, X is always first. Just alphabetical, really. Yeah?
Do we have homework?
Yes. Stay concentrated on this, please. You're wasting time. You're wasting everybody's time. Let's stay concentrated. So what is the change in Y? What's the change in Y?
1.8.
Only one player. Y changes 1.8. Y changes 1.8. Now how much does X change?
24.
So that means the $1.8 for every 24 miles driven. Right? That's kind of a strange way to put it.
That didn't come out nicely.
No, it did not come out nicely. So let's see, what would I do if I were in your shoes? I would change it to 18 over 240. Start simplifying. So let's see, these both are divisible by 2. This is 9 over 120. These are both divisible by 3. This is 3 over 40.
Kind of nicely.
Mm-hmm.
Nicer than
1.8. Nicer than having decimals.
Yeah.
So what does that mean to the person driving the car?
Every 3 miles they drive, they have to pay $40.
No, every 40 miles they spend $3.
Every 40 miles they drive, they have to spend $3. Remember, Y is dollars, X is miles. Change in Y over change in X, so dollars per mile. So $3 per 40 miles. Every 40 miles driven is $3. Why are these people driving on this road that costs them money like that?
That's a terrible thing.
The bus would cost you money if you were to ride in it, but that's not it's the actual road they're traveling on that costs them money.
Maybe it's
nothing to do with the bus. They're driving their own car on a particular road. Why would they drive on this road if it costs them money?
Like in Florida where I lived, they had stops, but you had to pay to drive on that road.
But why would you drive on the road if it costs money?
Maybe it's the only road that goes.
Sometimes it's the only road that goes the way you want to go in a reasonable amount of time, kind of like a shortcut. You can go a long way around, but
what if there isn't a long way around? It's the only possible way to go.
I don't know. There's toll roads that are the only way.
There could be.
No, maybe you can drive across the mountain. Yeah.
To drive
or
on
maybe
roads to go hunting that's costing
you. Cross the county line and then make you pay $2.
So usually it's because it's faster. Faster that way. There's a part of California that in San Diego that looks like this.
That's so cool.
And we call it, this was Coronado.
Maybe you
now if you live here and you want to get there, you could drive down here and do that. Or you could go across the Coronado Bridge. Right? Which we prefer. Cross the bridge, but the bridge costs money to make, so they would charge people money to cross the bridge.
How much?
And when you got on this side, I don't remember.
Wait,
since
you've actually been there?
I used to live in San Diego.
Oh, cool.
So when you got to the other side, they would charge you money to get onto Coronado Island, but the Coronado Bridge has been there for decades, and all that money has finally paid for the bridge and more, and so they don't charge you any money. But they used to, because it was much faster than going the other way. Carter?
There's this one bridge called the Victoria Bridge in Niagara Falls, and if you were there, it was like $10 to go across. It was like, wasn't even a mile long.
Yeah, I have to.
It was like $10 both ways.
Yeah. So, those are the kinds of roads that you pay to go on. They're shorter anyway. So it costs them $3 for every 40 miles, and we're just about done here. Explain the meaning of the slopes. Well, we did that already, didn't we?
Yeah.
Part B was to explain the meaning of the slope. The meaning of the slope is that. What is the meaning of the slope?
Every
40 miles, $3 I spent. So, quickly, another rundown here of slope. It's always the change in what?
Y.
Over the change in?
X.
And let me give you a common mistake that's made. Now that we've done a few of these, okay, maybe you've made this mistake, so you want to stay away from it. If I have a couple of points like 2, 4, and I don't want that comment there, and 7, negative 2, okay? A lot of times people will just always, when they're doing the subtraction to find the slope, just always put the bigger number first, okay? But that's not going to reflect the slope of the line. If it's a positive slope, it needs to be positive. If it's a negative slope, it needs to be negative. Okay? So, you subtract, when you subtract in the same order. You can subtract it. Let me show you. If I do 4 minus, first of all, it needs to be 4 minus negative 2, not 4 minus 2, because that number is a negative 2. Okay. So if I do 4 minus negative 2, I need to go in the same order now. I use the 4 from this point first, so I need to use the 2 from this point first.
Okay, so it's
2 minus 7. 2 minus 7. Now you might be tempted to do 7 minus 2, because 7 minus 2 comes out positive, but you can't just force it to be positive, otherwise you'd never get a negative slope.
I know what you mean.
Okay? So 4 minus negative 2, that's 4 plus 2, that's 6. Over 2 minus 7, that's negative 5. So our slope is negative 6 fifths. Okay, let's look at that on the graph. Here's 2, 4. 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 more. Negative 2 here. Okay. If we were to draw a line through those two points, then it would look like this. Question?
So, I don't know who it was. It was either, it was one of the other people in my grade that said that you can find the slope by just looking where the line meets.
X-axis.
Yeah, when it means that. That's what they said, and that didn't seem right, so.
Don't know. I mean, I guess you could, but you need 2 points. The point where it crosses the x-axis, to me, it looks like it crosses at a decimal somewhere. Mm-hmm. I don't know what that decimal is, so to say I can just see where it crosses the x-axis, that's my first faulty idea, is where does it cross the x-axis? I have no idea.
It looks like
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 point. I don't know, I'm just guessing at this point. Look at my graph. Is this a great graph?
No.
No, the x-axis curves upward. So that's kind of messing it up. You see what I'm saying? Like, there's so many different little errors that go into figuring out where this crosses the x-axis. We can figure that out, but we need to use these 2 points. Not just guessing where it crosses the x-axis. Kaden?
Okay, so there's that line and there's 2 points. You could take that either positive or negative. Like, you could start negative and go up to positive, or you could start positive
and
go down to negative.
And you'll get the same slope.
You will?
Yeah.
So if I started at the lower one,
mm-hmm.
and went, yeah, that negative 5, and then...
So start the lower one.
Yeah, I went negative 5 that way. Is it up first or that way?
Well, I just need the change in y or the change in x, so whichever you want to do first doesn't really matter.
Negative 5.
So I go back 5, right? So that's a negative 5.
And then, I have no idea how much up. That much up.
Well, we go up, but we're down here, right?
Yeah.
So we go up 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
6.
So up 6. Of course, that's what we already found.
And then, if you do from the top, it's
yep.
the same thing?
Well, it sort of, yeah. I mean, ultimately, yes, it is.
Positive 5. Yeah.
Right, but...
It's negative 6.
But it's negative 6. We go to the right 5, we go down 6. Both of these, negative 6 over 5 or 5, 6 over negative 5, they're both right, the same as negative the number 6 fifths.
Okay.
And if I were to, basically, let's see, what I did here was your second one, right?
What?
Let's see. I started here and wound up here. That's how I found 6 over negative 5. If I were to flip these around and go negative 2 minus 4. Okay. Now I need to follow that same order. I did negative 2 first, so I need to start with 7 first in the denominator, 7 minus 2. Negative 2 minus 4 is negative 6, and 7 minus 2 is positive 5. Right, there I get negative 6 over 5, here I get 6 over negative 5. Right. Kaden showed us what that looks like on the graph itself. Negative 6 over 5, 6 over negative 5. It's all the same. They're all equal to negative 6 fifths. The number negative 6 fifths. Right? So the slope is the same as what thing that I have said several times? The slope and what are the same thing?
Rate.
The rate of change, yeah. We saw, I think we upload that right here. Right? The slope of this line was 3 over 40. The meaning of that is that the rate of change of dollars to miles is $3 to 40 miles. The meaning is the rate. The rate of change of whatever y represents to whatever x represents. It might be miles per hour, inches per second, centimeters per minute, whatever it is. That's the rate that it represents. Sometimes you don't get any units, so it doesn't really represent a rate of dollars to miles. It just represents a change in y versus a change in x. Just an arbitrary y. Any questions? Do you think if you had 2 points, you could find a slope?
Yeah, we got this.
All right, we got this. Let's do this. Let's put everything away.
Okay,
questions?
Can you tell me,
okay,
I have
a positive slope. What kind of slope does this guy have?
Negative.
We see increase here, that's positive. We see a decrease here, that's negative.
But they both can be positive, they both could be negative.
This one will always be positive. We'll either get a positive x and a positive y, right? So we have positive over positive. Or a negative x and a negative y, but negative over negative is positive. Right, comes out positive. This one will either be a positive x, right? X, the change in x is in the denominator. Stop talking. It'll have a negative y change, which is a negative number, or it'll have a negative, let's see, yeah, it'll have a negative x, and a positive y change. Positive or negative is negative, negative divided by positive is negative, both of those come out to be negative. Right?
Uh-huh.
Agree?
Of course. Yes.
So, if I were just to really quickly, even just in my mind, plot these points and think, what kind of slope should I come out with? Here's 1, 4, something like that. 5, negative 3 is somewhere over there, right? So the line's going to look like something like that. So what kind of a slope should we expect to see?
Negative.
You could graph this a little better. You could count the slope off. You could just count over and down. But not necessary. We don't need to break all that out, right? We could just say, to find the difference in the y values, I could take negative 3 minus 4. If I take negative 3 minus 4, then we come back and go in the same order for the change in x and do 5 minus 1. So negative 3 minus 4 is negative 7, and 5 minus 1 is 4, so negative 7 fourths. So we move over 4 and down 7, and that would be the slope of this line, over 4 and down 7. That too quickly.
Or what? Over 7, or over 4 and up 7. No.
Left 4 and up 7, yeah.
Yeah.
It could be like that. If that would happen if we were to do 4 minus negative 3, right? Go this way, 4 minus negative 3 and 1 minus 5. Well, then we would get 4 plus 3 is 7, and 1 minus 5 is negative 4.
Could you just put like a negative like by the big bar?
That's what I would do. For my final answer, that's what I would give it. Just the 7 fourths is a negative, and I can interpret that as to the right 4 and down 7, or to the left 4 and up 7.
Okay.
Same. Cool. Good points to make.
Cool.
Okay, if I just quickly think about these points, negative 2, 3 is somewhere over there. 6, 12 is going to be out there somewhere. So we should see what kind of a slope?
We should see a positive slope.
Positive slope, right? Positive x, positive y change. Okay, to find the change in y, I can do 12 minus 3. Since I did 12 minus 3, I need to come back to 6 minus negative 2. 12 minus 3 is 9. 6 minus negative 2. 6 plus 2 is 8. So 9 eighths. 9 over 8 is this line. We go to the right 8 and up 9.
Yeah, I got that wrong. 50%.
I got
it.
I didn't know like how much does the water fill? I don't know.
You got the first one, like, because you got 6 over 4.
You could. You could say at 1 second it's 4 inches high, and at 5 seconds. I don't know why you guys continue to act in a way that just doesn't help you. The people who persistently are talking in class, I can tell. Not just by the talking. You get my drift. It does not help you. It's not helping you. It's not helping you. It doesn't help you. Stop doing it. Do things that would help you, like pay attention and ask questions and stop talking to people. And you know, I'm going to add, like, you agree, but not acting like you agree. If I were to treat this like 1 second and 4 inches, 5 seconds and negative 3 inches, it'd still work, right? I would see, like, if I treated this as the beginning, because 1 second is before 5 seconds, I would see a drop 7 inches, right? We go down 7 inches, that water. This goes from 4 all the way down to negative 3, so it goes down 7. And how many seconds go by from 1 second to 5 seconds? 4 seconds. So 4 seconds, every 4 seconds, we see a negative 7 inches, we see a drop of 7 inches. Even though negative 3 inches doesn't make a whole lot of sense in the context of a glass, still, it could work. You could think about that glass being like in the ground or something. Okay. We know the game here, right? We know how to figure out how quickly the glass is filling with water, but what I also want you to figure out is how much water was in it to begin with. I saw some of you doing this yesterday already without me asking. So I want to see what we can do with that. What is the rate that the glass is filling with water?
4 centimeters every 2 seconds.
Good. Which simplifies to down to what?
2 centimeters over 1 second.
Right. 2 centimeters over 1 second. Okay. How high was the water to start with at 0 seconds, right? Starting at 0 seconds. Tiana?
2 centimeters.
And how did you figure that out?
I figured that out because if it's 2 centimeters for every 1 second, and then you pass 5 seconds, it's 12 centimeters, then 5 by 2 times 2 is 10.
So you took the 12 centimeters and you said there's 2 centimeters for every second times 5 seconds. That's 12 minus 10. That's 2. Does that make sense?
Yep.
Here's your homework.
Okay, I need. Where's your homework?
On the board, right there. This problem. Your homework.
Oh.